And finally, we will see how to manage leases in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What happens in QuickBooks during a lease? Well, you first enter the main lease information into the lease document, which we know is an estimate. You can add any details from the contract that you need to always remember into the memo field or the description field right on the face of the lease estimate. Any other long-term information about the lease should really be kept in the notes section of the customer center in the tenant's records. And we saw those notes when we set up the customers on the customer or tenant list. You can attach a photocopy of the actual lease from the pay-per-click icon in the ribbon of the lease window, because almost every transaction document in QuickBooks Online allows you to attach a document like a picture or a file to any of the transactions. You just open the lease each month to record an invoice against the lease when each monthly invoice comes. And that's it. Those are the steps, and it's very, very simple. So, for example, let's imagine on April 1, we made a lease for candy for 24 months. Same rent, $1,000 per month. Let's check it out. So, we come here, and we know we have to click the plus sign and come across to estimate. Now, remember, even though it says estimate here, when we print it, it will say lease agreement, because we made sure of that in the previous video. Now this customer is Candy Charles, and the date of this lease agreement is April 1. I believe it's April 1. Yes, it's April 1. Now, the product or service is obviously the rent due. Now, we know that the rent due is at the rate of $1,000 a month, because that's the rate of her monthly rent. But there will be 24 months, push the tab key on the left of your keyboard. There will be 24 months in this lease, which means the total amount of the lease is $24,000. Starts on April 1. Now, we have not earned one penny of this until time goes by. But at the beginning, we have a $24,000 contract, which is really a lease agreement that starts on April 1 and runs 24 months for $1,000 each. You can add information that's on the physical contract right here in the message displayed, the message displayed on statement, and here's the paperclip where you can attach a picture or a file that represents the actual paper, document, or picture of the lease. So this is everything you need. You can add lease information in the description field and so on. Now, it's good to add an expiration date, and we know if we're 24 months in the future, I'm not going to click the forward arrow 24 months. I'm simply going to put 2 years later, 2021. So the lease starts on April 1 of 2019, and it ends on April 1, which is almost the same as March 31st, of 2021. And that would be, 2021. 24 months, 2 years, looks good enough. So now we're going to click Save. Now, how do we know we made a lease that we haven't earned anything from yet? Well, we close this and we look on the report that we set up in the previous video. Click Reports, Custom Reports, Estimate Progress, Invoice Summary, Customer, click, whatever. Notice that this here, $24,000 specifically for Candy Charles. Now, this is here because of Candy is under Meadow Lane, but don't worry about that. Just open up, you just have to, yeah, okay. I'll open up Candy Charles, and you see that you have a $24,000 lease that status is pending because we haven't made any invoices yet, and that there's 0% invoiced. So now we're ready for the next step. Now you will really see the power of this when we enter our first invoice. I'm going to show you April's invoice and what the result is, May's invoice, what the result is, and so on. So when we make the invoice, we set it against the specific lease. The way to do that is to double click and open the lease itself. When you open the lease itself from the same place each month, you go to the top right and create invoice. That's the only way to be absolutely sure that the invoice will be matched against this particular lease. Click create invoice. Now, will it be for everything a certain percent or a custom amount for each line? We're going to click custom amount for each line and click create invoice. Now, QuickBooks knows it's 0 out of 24, and that's the product. And we're going to put the quantity, we're going to put 1. So the amount will be 1,000, and the quantity shows up as 1 if we put 1,000, because we know it's 1,000 a month for 24 months. That's the way we did it when we set up the lease. So now if we click away, click in any field to save this field, now it looks the way it's supposed to. And when we click save and close, something went wrong and they're working on it. But what they mean is we have to click reports and go back to this good report to kind of make it fresh. Aha. Notice the lease is there. It's lease number 1004 or whatever number you want to put. The total amount is here. But the invoiced amount is here, the invoiced percent is here, and the remaining balance of the lease is here. So if you have many leases across many years for many tenants, this report will help you manage it if you put it into the computer this way. Now, on one sad and final note, I have some bad news about leases. Automated invoices from the memorized transactions, or in our case, the reoccurring transaction list, cannot be applied to lease estimates. So you have a choice. You can make the invoices yourself from the estimates window, like we just did, or you can automate the invoices and set up a custom report so that you can see here's the total estimate and here are all the invoices. But it's not as good. So I wish you good luck with your choice and your leases.